Hey guys, I have another hands-free practice for you today. By hands-free, I don't necessarily mean we won't use our hands at all. You might use your hands to help you transition in and out of a pose or from seated to standing, or maybe to grab hold of your foot in a stretch or something like that. But what we're not gonna do is weight bearing on our hands. So no plank type of poses. So this is a good practice for you if you have some issues with your wrist or just want to take a break from that in your practice today. It's still going to be fairly active. We're going to do lots of stuff with our legs, some balancing work, in addition to some more gentle stretching. So we'll get started standing. You may have wondered why I'm standing since I start everything else seated. Feet a little bit wider than the hips. And we're going to swing our arms from side to side. And you can let as much of your body turn with you as you like. Letting the arms just kind of flap. Make sure that you are breathing well and just being aware of your breathing. In and out through the nose is the most natural way to breathe. If it feels good for you to exhale some through your mouth, that works too. As long as you're breathing, you're good. We're gonna start to slow this down to let it come to a halt. And then we're gonna do some side reaching from side to side. So reach one arm over, get longer down that side, come back down and reach to the other side. Yeah, inhale as you reach, exhale back down. If you want to add a little more leg work, bend your knees when you're down. And as you reach, maybe up on the tippy toes on that side. Last one. All right, from here, I'm gonna get my feet right at about hip width. Right, as we inhale, we'll reach both arms up and look up just a little bit. Exhale, we'll try to keep a fairly straight line with our backs as we fold as far down as we can, and maybe we bend the knees a little bit. Right, and then we'll keep the knees bent as we, instead of coming up straight, we'll sort of roll up. And exhale, stand. Roll the shoulders down. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, try to stay a little more straight as we fold. Knees are bent as we inhale, round up. Exhale, stand, roll the shoulders. Let's do that a few more times. I'll turn to this side so you can get a different view. Inhale, exhale. Inhale. Let's do one more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. All right. From here, we're going to do a cat-cow type of movement standing. So we'll be arching and rounding the back a little bit, adding arms for help. I'll show you from two different views. So as we inhale, we're gonna keep a little bit of the knees the whole time. Inhale, we'll reach arms wide, palms are facing forward, chest lifts, hips can go back, look up. Exhale, we'll tuck the pelvis, round the shoulders, tuck the chin, bring hands forward. Inhale, and exhale. Let's do a few more rounds. I'll turn to the side. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Let's do one more round. be standing on the right foot, and you can always grab hold of a surface for help balancing if you like. Right, make sure that leg feels really, really rooted down and strong. And we're gonna lift the left knee up as high as we can without trying to move other things too much. Back and forth a few times. Up and down. Next time it's up, we're gonna see if we can slowly start to step back for a lunge, ball the back foot. All right, once we're there, we're kind of check in, make sure we're about hip width with the feet, otherwise we might feel a little too wobbly. All right, think tailbone down and ribs in. All right, and we're gonna lower the back knee halfway or maybe a little bit more and then back up a few times. Exhale, inhale. We'll go all the way down this time. Letting that leg get a nice rest after all that work. All right, from here we're gonna take the arms open wide, palms are facing forward, right? Still thinking of tailbone down and ribs in. Right, we're gonna turn that whole upper body set up to the right. As far as we can. Noticing it's hard to breathe. And we'll turn back forward and then open to the left, letting the legs work a little bit to help balance. We'll turn back forward and then we'll rotate thumbs down, palms back, internal rotation of the shoulders. We'll reach back and find a hand clasp. Inhale, pull down, lift your chest, arch a little bit. Exhale, fold. Right? You don't have to go super far down. You might kind of snuggle right inside your thigh. You can drop your head. Balance is a little tricky. All right. So we'll take the hands down. We'll curl the back toes under and lift the back knee and then step forward into an easy fold. Maybe bend the knees, grab elbows and sway a little bit. And then we'll do that stuff on the other side. All right, settling into mountain pose. Feet about hip width. We'll engage the leg we're gonna stand on, really root down into the foot. And we'll lift the right knee up and down a few times, as high as it'll go for hip flexion without otherwise changing other things, right? Try not to let your back change or your weight shift too much. This time we'll step it back for that lunge, ball the back foot. All right, we'll take a moment to make sure we've got enough width so we're not too wobbly. All right, we'll make sure we're not arching too much in our back, stick ribs in, tailbone down. And we'll take the back knee part of the way down and back up. Exhale down, inhale up. All the way down. All right. We'll take the arms out nice and wide. And we'll turn to the left. And forward. And to the right. And forward. We'll rotate. Palms down. Palms back, thumbs down. Reach back, find your hand clasp. Inhale, a little pull. Exhale, fold. And breathe. All right, we'll take the hands down. We'll curl the
fold again. All right, maybe again, grabbing elbows, knees bent, swaying, whatever feels nice. And we'll come on up from here.
All right, we're gonna start in a similar way to the last sequence, but take it into a little bit of a different place from here. So we're gonna be standing again on the right foot back to the first side. We'll lift the left knee up, this time just about hip height, not too high. We're gonna see if we can find a twist from here. Taking the right hand outside that leg, turning the chest, and reaching the left arm back, and breathing. Keep the leg there and untwist. Let's see if we can extend that leg forward any amount. Try not to let the hip lift or lean back or anything. Your quads might get a little angry. We'll start to lower that leg, keep it straight, and we're gonna take a shorter step back to set up pyramid. Legs are straight, both heels are down. You do not have to be lined up with your feet, right? You might find that extra wobbly, right? A little bit of width is good, right? Squaring the hips forward, using your hands for help. Keep the left hip forward and the right hip back, and then get really long as you reach forward into your fold, noticing your hips want to kind of take the path of least resistance and trying to get them to stay more square. Hands might slide down your leg. You could have blocks here for your hands, right? We started this sequence with a twist to the left. We're going to take it now to a twist to the right. Lower half is going to stay the same. We'll get a little bit longer and taller again. We'll check with the hips and try to keep them level. Right, you might have your left hand on your right leg. We'll turn the chest to the right and reach the right arm up, revolve triangle. All right, we'll release that twist. We'll come back up to standing. Right, a little bend in that front leg. As we go back to our knee lifted position, we're gonna see if we can find eagle from here. So we'll bend the standing leg and cross that knee on top. Hips are back like chair pose. You can take your left toes down, right, on the floor or a block for some balance help. Foot can just kind of hang, foot can wrap behind. Left leg is on top, we'll do left arm underneath. And release. Okay, my right leg is getting tired. How about yours? Let's switch over to the left side. Okay, engage left leg. We'll lift that right knee up about hip height. And we'll start to twist to the right. Left hand can come outside. Right arm reaches back. Untwist. And let's try extending that leg. Try not to lean back or cock the hip up. It's really hard. My leg is shaking. Lower the leg. Shorter step back. 2 to 3 feet. Legs straight. Heels down. Pyramid. Square the hips forward. And then we'll think really long spine as we fold. Maybe you take hands to your leg, down to your mat, to some blocks. Okay, and then we'll try our revolve triangle twist from here. I'm gonna use right hand on that left foot. Getting long and rotating to the left. Left arm reaches up. Breathing. All to our knee lift position. Crossing over into eagle. Think hips back like chair. Maybe a toe wrap. That's a little harder. Maybe toes down for balance. Right arm under. You could always just give yourself a hug too, right? Those eagle arms are a little tricky. And release. Maybe a little leg shaking. Okay. From here, we'll come into chair pose for just a moment. And we'll see if we can go from chair to a seated position. You can bring your arms forward as you start to get lower. You can use your hands for help to lower, or maybe see what you got. Once you're up, lift into a boat pose, knees bent. Maybe your arms are forward, maybe fingertips are down. Try to sit up nice and tall. We're gonna try a twist from here in boat. And if it's too much, you can come right back to this one and you can come out whenever you need to. I'm going to cross my right ankle under my left ankle. And then I'm going to grab that right big toe, the one that's underneath, with my right index and middle fingers. I'm going to turn to the left and try to extend my legs and reach my arm up so that I'm trying to make like a V with arm and legs. And then I'll bend the knees. On twist, switch to cross. Grab hold of that big toe, turn, maybe extend, maybe reach up. Release, untwist, uncross. Maybe, if you want to be playful, try grabbing both of your big toes and try more of an extended boat pose. Sometimes I fall backwards in this one. Bend your knees, rest your feet down. You can rest your arms on your knees and rest your head on your arms and just take a moment here. All right, we'll come up from here. I'm gonna widen my feet a little bit and just kind of take my hands behind me and windshield wiper the knees from side to side. And the opposite hip lifts as I go to one side. Okay, next time I'm over to the left, I'm going to stay over there and get my legs into more of a specific degree of bend, 90-90, so 90 degree bend with both legs. So we're going for hip, knee, ankle at a right angle with both legs. There's the 90-90. Right, flex both feet, and then we're turning toward that front leg a little bit, and then leaning forward into a folded position. We should feel a little bit of something in the front hip, right, the front leg. Okay, we're gonna keep those legs and come upright. And I'm gonna try not to lean too much. I'm gonna try to sit as upright as I can. I'm gonna keep my back knee down to start as I try lifting that back shin up and down a few times. And it doesn't go very far. I'm working on this hip back here, internal rotation. All right, and then I'm gonna try to lift the whole leg and bring it forward and kind of stagger it in front of the other leg, and they're still attempting somewhat of a 90 degree angle, right? This is kind of like a loose variation on fire logs or double pigeon, and lean forward and get a deeper hip stretch than we did with the 90-90 position. Okay. And then we'll come up out of that fold. We'll lift the top leg, and it's still in sort of a 90-degree angle. We'll see if we can take it back where it was in our 90-90. And then we'll lift the knees up, and we'll take them over to the other side. Yeah? And I'm going to switch and turn so that you can see me on the other side. All right, so we are 90-90, and the right leg is the front leg this time. And we're thinking hip, knee, ankle for that right angle. And then we'll take our little fold toward the front leg. Try not to lean too much. You can have hands down somewhere. Back knee stays down, and we'll try lifting the back foot, shin a few times, feeling that work and internal rotation for that hip. It feels a little icky, a little tricky. Okay, and then we'll lift that whole leg and bring it forward and find our sort of loose fire logs position. Right, and then we'll forward fold here and get a deeper hip stretch. Okay, and we'll come up and we'll see if we can lift this front shin and take it back where it was in our 90-90 position. We'll lift the knees back up, slide the heels forward. I'll turn and face you for a wide-legged forward fold. And you might have something out in front of you to rest on if you like. You could also prop your hips up on a pillow or a block or blanket. We're gonna come onto our bellies next. Do a little shoulder and back work. All right, so lying on your belly, we're gonna make, same as we did 90-degree angles with our legs in that position just a little while ago, we're gonna try to get 90-degree angles with our arms, right? So usually I refer to this as cactus arms or goalpost arms. Right, so we're trying to get the elbows straight out from the shoulders and then the forearm perpendicular. Okay, all right, nice straight line here. Lift your head just a little bit, but don't look forward, right? Just look straight down so the neck is long. We're going to make fists, and we're going to keep the elbows down, just like we kept our knees down and tried to lift the shin and the foot. We're going to try to keep elbows down as we lift the forearms back and forth, and we're trying to keep the wrist straight. And good gravy, it's harder than it looks, guys. Lots of shoulder work. We'll stretch it out in just a moment, I promise. Let's do one more. Okay, and then we'll release the fist to keep the cactus arms. Right, send your tailbone down towards your heels, hips into the mat, engage your backside. Right, and we'll lift the chest with the cactus arms for a cactus arm baby cobra. And lower down. Let's try that a few times. Let's stay up this time. And the legs, reach the arms back. Focus. Lower down and wiggle the hips. And then let's press back into child's pose. You can do knees wide, knees together, but think
soft with your back, maybe slightly rounded to counter the back bending. Noticing that maybe your breath got a little faster, heart rate got a little bit up during that back bending work. It may have been a little surprising. Okay, let's lift the upper body just a little bit, keeping the hips back. We're gonna walk the hands to the left, several inches, like as far as you can reach. And then I'm gonna take my left hand a little closer toward my feet, elbow bent, fingertips down. I'm kind of pushing with that hand, really reaching through my right fingertips, and then I'll let my head go down. I'm feeling lots of stretching in my right armpit. And we'll walk that over to the other side. Right elbow is bent, right fingertips near my right leg. Really inching the left fingertips forward and bowing down. And lifting up, walking back to center, coming up. Let's come down to our backs from here. Give the knees a hug in toward the chest and rock a little bit. All right, and then we'll do a spinal twist. So there's lots of variations on a spinal twist lying down. You can just drop both knees over to the right. Since we did eagle pose earlier, I like to usually include that at the end as well. So I'm gonna cross my left knee over my right knee. You don't have to tuck your foot behind, but you can try if you want to. And then we'll drop legs to the right. Your top knee may not make it all the way down, mine doesn't. I like to, or prefer to keep my shoulders down a little bit more. You could always prop your legs up with a pillow or a block. You can look over the opposite shoulder. Breathe. Switch to cross so the right leg is on top, legs go to the left. Right. Maybe look over the opposite shoulder. All right, check your shoulders. Soles of the feet together, knees wide, or climb down to angle. Heels close in, further away, whatever feels like it's your sweet spot, your happy medium, Goldilocks, not too hot, not too cold position. All right, make space for neck and shoulders. Arms can rest wherever you like. We'll take just a few deep breaths here, letting ourselves settle down into our mats. And then let's stretch all the way down with the legs for Shavasana. All right, you could always keep knees bent and feet down if your low back bothers you, lying flat, or maybe just put some pillows up under your knees. Close your eyes.
natural, effortless. And allow yourself this last little bit of time to rest. Start to take some deeper breaths and to invite gentle movement by wiggling fingers and toes. Rotate wrists and ankles. Reach the arms overhead, stretch along the fingertips through your toes. Hug your knees in. Hold your chest and rock from side to side. Rolling over to your side as you're ready, resting there. Very gently press up to seated. Eyes closed, hands together at your heart. Take a moment